Hello, welcome to In Studio. I'm Ian M. Butterfield. In this video, I'm going to show you how to use graduated filters in Adobe Lightroom. I received an email this week from one of my subscribers, Alison, who was asking me about using graduated filters within Lightroom. So I thought this would make a good video cast. So let me just explain a little bit about the background to using filters in Lightroom. And to do that, let's start with how you would use graduated filters in camera. Typically, if you've got a scene such as this, which is the Roman Forum in Rome, where the sky is blown out and there's no detail in there, you'd solve that problem by using a graduated filter. A graduated filter reduces the amount of light on the top half of the image, but has no effect on the bottom half. And there's a transition area in the middle. Now, you can place these in front of the camera and you can turn them around so that the line, the transition area, goes along the horizon. So with this scene, that, as you can see, is how the forum was recorded without any filters on. If I used a neutral density graduated filter, you can see that I'm now able to capture some of the detail in the sky. There are coloured versions, such as blue ones. Personally, I think the blue sky, when done in camera, is probably the least effective. However, a tobacco coloured one can give a sort of sepia sort of effect. So how would we do this in post-production in Lightroom? Well, I've got an image here of a boat that was, or a wreck I should say, on the coast at Fleetwood. There's some detail in the sky, but not a huge amount, and I'd like to accentuate that by using a graduated filter in Lightroom. Now, one of the things I have to say, if you're planning to do this effect, you need to make sure that the detail is actually there in the sky to be brought out. If the sky is completely blown out, you won't be able to bring back any information at all. So let's have a look at what we're going to do with this. Well, first of all, let's just do a little bit of basic production on this, developing on this. I'm going to go over to the develop module and I'll just set a few settings on here. The first setting I'm going to play with is the exposure. I'm just going to lighten it very, very slightly, about half a stop, just to try and bring out a little bit of the detail in the image. And I'm also going to bring up the shadows just a bit to try and bring out, ooh, a bit too far, bring out the detail just inside the wreck. Now, there's not much detail in the sky, so I want to sort of bring that back a little bit with a graduated filter. And to do that, you can choose the filters on the toolbar here, and you're looking for this particular little rectangle, or pressing M on the keyboard, and we've got it on there. Now, the sort of settings we want with this, I'm just going to reset everything first of all, and we're going to want to take the exposure down probably by, I would say, about a half a stop, a full stop. Let's start with, yeah, about two-thirds of a stop, nearly a full stop, and let's see how that goes. And if I then draw vertically down, you can see we're starting to bring, we've got that detail coming into the sky. And we get this transition area, which goes between the top line there, where anything above it is maximum effect, anything below the bottom line is zero effect, and the transition is in the middle. I'm going to bring this down a fraction to try and get it along the horizon. Now, I think we can shorten that transition down just a little bit. And by putting the cursor on the side, I can rotate it around to try and line it up with the horizon. So I think something around there. Now, I'm going to play with the exposure just a little bit to bring it down till I've got the amount of detail I want in the sky. And that's starting to look quite reasonable. Now, one of the questions I was asked about this is, how do we put colour into the sky? Well, we have this little checkbox at the bottom. When there's an X in it, as you can see at the moment, that means there's no colour effect. If we click on that, we can then choose a colour. So I'm going to try blue to try and give it a bit of a bluey tint to it. If I click here, we can see the effect on there, and I can just play around with this to find a colour I like. If I wanted sepia tone, I could come over here and get that kind of effect. I'm going to go with blue on this over here, and that's the sort of blueness I think will work for this image. And just click off the picker. So that's given us the effect there. And that looks okay. But what you can see is we've got a problem over here in that because the top part of the boat is poking up into the sky, it's taken on the darkening effect and particularly the blue effect. And we want to correct for that. Now, there's another way of getting the blue effect, which makes it a little bit easier for us to correct this in post-production. And that is not to have a colour selected there. So I bring it down to the bottom left-hand corner, and that will give me no colour effect. But instead, to use the temperature slider. And if I pull that down to the blue end, I think that the effect of that is a little more subtle, a little more pleasing in terms of what we do with the sky there. And I'm just going to move that exposure down again. Oh, too far. Just trying to find the point where this works nicely. I think also it would be good to put in just a little bit of clarity because that will help bring out the detail in the sky. So I'm going to push the clarity up. Yeah, and that's beginning to work. So bring the clarity up to about 36 on there. We've got some nice detail there. Maybe a little bit of contrast. Yeah, that's making the sky look really quite dramatic now. Just that little bit of contrast in there. But we still need to deal with this section here. So I'm going to come out of the graduated filter. And looking at the image at the moment, I think there's a couple of things I want to do to the image overall. I'm just going to push the clarity up a little bit to the whole image. That gives it a little bit more bite in there. And push the saturation or vibrance up. I'll push the vibrance up just to add a bit of colour. Now, having done that, the sky is now taken on too much of a blue effect to it. So I'm going to go back into that, that graduated filter. And click on the control pin, and I'm just going to take the exposure back a fraction to something about there. That's looking a little bit more reasonable. And I'm just going to bring that graduation point down just a little bit more to capture all the sky. Now we need to deal with the prow of the boat and remove the effects that the graduated filter has put in. So to do that, we're going to hit either the K key or use the adjustment brush here, same effect. What we're going to do now is dial in the exact opposite of the effects we put in with the graduated filter. So I used a lot of blue color balance, so I'm going to make that up to orange a reasonable way. I took the exposure down, so I'm going to by a stop, so I'm going to bring it up by about a stop. I put some clarity in, so I'm going to take some clarity out, just a small amount. And I think those were the main items that I did. Now, looking down at how we use the brush on here, we want to have the auto mask set. That means it will hold onto the edges of the particular parts that I'm going to paint on. I'm going to bring the flow down to about 50%. And I'm going to make my brush size just a little bit smaller. And now I'm just going to paint in on here. I'm going to paint over a few times and we should start to see those changes coming into effect. Now, what you will notice with this is I've got the screen recording software going, which means the way in which this will appear on your screen will be, it will take a little while to happen. And that's purely a feature of the screen recording software. It's not seeing every brush stroke that I've got. Now, the reason I took the flow right down is during the transition area, if I go up too much down here, I'm going to overcompensate. So I'm just going to paint down here, try and bring the colours back. And we can just about see it happening over here, a little gentler down here. And I'm going to go now, I think that's most of the transition area dealt with. I'm just going to bring the flow right up to 100 just to deal with the areas which are definitely not in the transitional part. So you can see, hopefully, the blue cast on this is now disappearing. Returning the prow back to its normal sort of colours that we would expect. So you can take a little bit more care over this when you're doing it on your own images. Bring the flow back down a little bit around here, because I think we need just slightly less than full amount on there. And I think that's fairly reasonable with that image. Whilst I'm talking about graduated filters, I just want to talk about one final thing in here, and that's the radial filter. Works exactly the same way as the graduated filters, except it's circular or elliptical. So let me show you how I would use that. Again, reset all the effects on it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this to create a vignetting effect. Rather than using the standard vignette, which would just do equally on all sides, the ship's sort of off-center. So I'd like the vignette just to highlight the ship, and it's a sort of, it would, rather than highlighting some of the areas over here. So I'm just going to take the exposure down by about 2/3 of a stop. I then click in the middle of the image and then just draw out this ellipse. And you can see how the items around the outside of it have got the effect of being a little bit darker and inside hasn't. I've pulled out the ellipse to that sort of size. I can adjust it as I wish in and out here. What I'm actually going to do is if you hold it near the line, you'll get the rotate symbol coming up on the mouse. I'm going to just rotate it round. To about there. And then move it up. Position it into about here. Now that gives, I'm just going to see if I can darken it a little bit more. That's perhaps a little bit too far. But you can see there we've got this masking effect on there. So I'm just going to take that, come out of the filter so we don't get the mask on. And that's pulled our attention in towards the boat. We've now got this nice coloured sky, we've got a bit of highlighting in the middle, we've got the detail all there. So just to recap what we've done with this image. We started off with standard processing, we've adjusted the colour with it using exposure. We've used a graduated filter to bring out the detail in what was just about a blown out sky. We added color to it. First of all, we did it with the color selector, and then we redid it with using the color temperature to create the blue effect. And we solved the problem of part of the image sticking into that graduated filter by painting out the complete opposite of what we'd put in with the filter. And then finally, we added a non-standard shaped vignette using the elliptical filter, graduated filter, just to highlight the center of the image and to darken everywhere else just slightly. So I hope this tutorial has been useful and has given an overview of how to use those tools in Lightroom. My thanks to Alison for sending the question in. If anybody else has got photography related questions, please feel free to email me or add them in the comments field below this video. I can't promise I'll deal with all of them, but hopefully some will form great ideas for future video casts. So as ever, please subscribe to this channel, subscribe to my weekly photography newsletter with all its hints and tips, and as ever, thanks for watching. This has been an in-studio video presentation by Ian M. Butterfield. All content and photographs are copyright Ian M. Butterfield and may not be reproduced without prior permission. For more information, including how to subscribe to this and other videos, please visit www.ians-studio.co.uk/videos. Thank you.